I think we were just driving somewhere and we saw a flyer, an ad for a coffee open house at CSG. And I went to public school growing up and my husband went to private school. And I've always been like, oh, you know, public school is fine. It's great. And, you know, and it is. But then I came to Columbus School for Girls and I was just blown away by the first visit.
Sanvi is our older. She's 5 years old. She's in kindergarten here at CSG. And then Saya is our younger one. She's in the PYC as well. She's in the 4-5 class.
Both great girls, completely opposite personalities.
You know, I would say ever since our daughters were born, you know, the cooler talk, talk at the dinner table, pillow talk between me and my wife, a lot of it was about schooling and, you know, where we're going to send our girls for school. It was not a decision that we took lightly for it by any means. In some of the curriculum, like our, for example, my younger daughter, she's not even in kindergarten yet, but she's already working with girls in like the middle school and the upper school, working on engineering projects of how to, you know, make a water pump. They have a water pump in the back of their playground. So the girls have identified that as a problem because every time they use the water pump, you know, the whole playground gets wet. No, I'm talking about 4-year-olds and 3-year-olds. So now that they've identified that as a problem, they're working with girls in like in the engineering class to figure out how are they going to move that water. And it's something small, but I think that becomes more and more powerful as they continue to, you know, explore those different topics.
My older one, she was very fearful, you know, just like, for example, just going out on the playground and balancing on things. And, you know, and even though it's such a small, simple concept of, oh, you can balance on something, that they wanted to show her that you can do this, and once you do it, how does that feel, that confidence that you had a problem and you solved it yourself?
So we live in Dublin, so we have about a, you know, 35 to 45 minute commute. For the most part, I would say, it's something that I look forward to. You know, as soon as they jump in the car, they have, you know, 500 things that they want to talk about. They want to get their snacks first, of course, and then they, you know, want to share something about their day.
Just the way that the girls have learned to communicate and reflect on things, that makes the time with them actually a little bit more meaningful. That time that we're with the girls, yeah, 30 minutes, 45 minutes in the car is painful at sometimes in traffic, but I also think that because of the way they've been in school and, you know, looked at things and become reflective, that time is so meaningful too.